magic in mushrooms. There's new research that suggests psychedelic drugs may help some patients with depression and anxiety. Here to talk about that is Dr. Michelle DiBlasi, a psychiatrist at Tufts Medical Center. Happy New Year, Doctor.
Hey, Doctor. It's great to see you. So I've been looking at this list of drugs, and there are shrooms, there's LSD, there's ecstasy. You say those three things, and people go, what? So why do mental health experts think that they offer significant health benefits?
Yeah, I have to say it is kind of startling seeing things like LSD, magic mushrooms, ecstasy, being told that these could have positive benefits for our mental health. But there is new research that's starting to show that the main ingredients in some of these psychedelic drugs like MDMA and ecstasy could help with some people with post-traumatic stress disorder, or psilocybin, which is found in magic mushrooms, or LSD could help with depression or anxiety. But again, these are only in certain populations, and of course, under very strict medical monitoring and dosing. Mm-hmm.
So the research sounds interesting. Totally illegal. Are there other risks?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I think the biggest risk is that this is now going to start to be really big in the headlines. I mean, we're already talking about it, right? And so people are going to start seeing this, you know, that magic mushrooms and LSD and ecstasy could be helpful. And so I really think the biggest risk is people starting to self-experiment with these things. And so I just want to remind people that, yes, they could be promising for helping people in the future. But again, these studies are going to be done under really careful medical monitoring, and only in the right patient population, right? Some of these actual psychedelic drugs could harm people, right? If you have like bipolar disorder or are prone to psychosis or have schizophrenia. So we need to be really careful and wait until all the evidence sort of unfolds and is reviewed.
And that was wonderfully put. So, but given all of that, Doctor, let's just kind of look at the future. In your opinion, does one appear to have more potential than the others and maybe get a shot at FDA approval?
You know, I feel like actually at least one of these may get FDA approval maybe by the end of even 2024, so within the next year. I mean, MDMA has been showing some really, you know, robust studies for people who are struggling with post-traumatic stress disorder. So that's a possibility. You know, like I mentioned, psilocybin for depression. And so I think in the next year to 2 years, some of these may actually get FDA approval. And so I think there's a lot more research to come, but I know I'm pretty excited to see if maybe we can have more tools in our toolbox to work with people who are really struggling with severe mental illness.
Dr. Michelle DiBlasi, thank you so much for being with us.
Happy
Stay
New
well.
Year. Great to see you. Take care.